magical plot-solving button. Are you saying that you don't know who Doctor Who is?
It's time to talk, ladies and gentlemen, about the elephant in the room. Doctor Who. While we were gone, the BBC announced that a woman would be playing the next incarnation of the Doctor. And I am absolutely outraged. I cannot believe that the BBC has done something so petty. It's just disgraceful, and I may never watch the show again. Because as we all know, Teatime with Matt came up with that idea first. And not only did they nick the idea, but they didn't cast Emily Caroline Edwards. It's like the last 8 years of our campaigning didn't even happen. I am furious. Oh, man. Ugh. But it's not the first time Doctor Who writers have pinched stuff from this show. Oh, no. Far from it. In fact, here's a list of things that Doctor Who has pinched from Teatime with Matt. First thing that Doctor Who's pinched from Teatime with Matt, friendly Daleks. I created the character of Derek the Dalek way back in 2005. For our new listeners, Derek the Dalek appeared as in a radio sitcom called Scratchwood, which was set in an alternative universe where there were still steam trains in regular use, and aliens turned up to ruin lunch every other day. Derek was a regular character who worked as a cleaner and security guard at Scratchwood Junction, having quit his job with the Dalek Empire due to being refused a request for some sick leave. Derek's character later transitioned onto the YouTube series The Adventures of Derek and Matt and The Cult of Scratchwood, which is essentially a sitcom about me sharing a flat with some Daleks. Now, Stephen Moffat pinched this idea not once, but twice. Friendly Daleks featured in the Series 7 episode Asylum of the Daleks with the character of Osman Oswald, and again in the Series 8 story Into the Dalek, with a broken Dalek called Rusty. It's blatant. Second one, returning villains in disguise. In 2010, we performed a sketch entitled Planet of the Huggable Teddy Bears. In it, Emily Edwards went to Stephen Moffat to argue with him about a Valentine's Day special that he'd written. It was revealed that Stephen Moffat wasn't actually Stephen Moffat at all, but was in fact Russell T. Davis in disguise. Russell had apparently kidnapped the real Stephen Moffat and taken his place, intending to make the series a laughingstock so that the BBC would beg him to come back. Stephen was clearly unimpressed with this sketch, because he nicked the idea for the Series 10 episode World Enough and Time. In this story, a character called Razor takes care of the Doctor's companion Bill Potts for a whole decade before revealing that he's actually a past incarnation of the Master in disguise, which is rather necessary when you happen to be someone's former Prime Minister. Third, Time Lord's flirting with previous incarnations. Also in 2010, we performed another sketch entitled The Last Doctor. In it, Emily travelled back in time to confront the Daleks and the 11th Doctor, as portrayed by Matt Smith. At the end of the sketch, Emily's Doctor admits she thinks the 11th Doctor is kind of cute, and the two flirt outrageously before disappearing into the TARDIS to... Well, I think it's probably best not to think about that too much. In the the series 10 finale, The Doctor Falls, the Master and Missy, a future incarnation of the Master, flirt outrageously with each other. While it was funny in the context of Teatime with Matt, it's honestly just a bit awkward. Stephen, if you're going to steal my ideas, at least do it in a context that isn't creepy, yeah? Number 4. Ridiculous spin-offs. In a 2011 sketch entitled The Spin-Off Media of Doom, Russell T. Davis returns to trap the Doctor in a script for the ACT spin-off show K9 and Company. He also reveals he plans to write a rubbish spin-off entitled Time Tots of Gallifrey. Patrick Ness, acclaimed young adult author and obviously a fan of Teatime with Matt, pinched this idea and wrote Class, a Doctor Who spin-off set in Coal Hill School, or as it is now known, the Coal Hill Academy, as obviously with all the alien invasions taking place there, the GCSE results for the whole school are atrocious. Featuring the exploits of a group of sixth formers, Class shows this gang of obnoxious teenagers struggling with schoolwork, relationships, literal amputation, seriously, and alien life forms that want to murder everyone in the school, followed by the planet. Also along for the ride is Miss Quill, a teacher at the school who isn't what she seems. Ooh. There's also a series arc about one of the sixth formers being the sole surviving member of an alien race whose planet got destroyed, who happens to be a prince of that species, and flat shares with Miss Quill, who is duty-bound to protect him thanks to an alien parasite in her brain which will kill her if he comes to harm. And seriously, this whole thing is totally ridiculous! It's no wonder the whole show got cancelled after one series. Even the awesome plot twist at the end, which set up a conspiracy involving the Weeping Angels, wasn't enough to save it. I mean, dear God, Patrick! If you're going to copy my ideas, at least copy a decent one! And that, folks, was a list of things that Teatime with Matt has licked from... the Doctor Who, rather, has nicked from Teatime with Matt. Granted, that does happen the other way quite a lot as well, but still, you know, don't nick my ideas. Chibnall, you and me need to have words before you start the next series, okay? I got my eye on you.